Hi, welcome in another video of Cloud in 5 Minutes. Today, I want to talk about the Azure DevOps projects. Are they really worth it? Aussi, si vous préférez, j'ai une version en français de ce vidéo. Cliquez juste ici, en haut à droite. So the other day I saw that DevOps projects were available now in Azure and I was curious to see exactly what's come with it. So I decided to create it and I really liked it. So let's create one. So from the Azure portal, let's go and click on that plus and then we'll look for DevOps. So we see DevOps projects. This is exactly what we want. So we'll go click create. And now we have multiple projects template that were suggested to us. So we need, let's scroll this way. So now we have multiple projects that are available to us. So we have .NET, Java, static website, Node.js, and you could even provide your own code. So just for today, let's go and create the static website. So of course, I'm in a static website, so I don't have a lot of frameworks right now. For example, if you pick .NET, you will have the choice between the regular .NET or .NET Core. So let's go with the static website. And now I decide, will I go with container or a web app? So let's take a web app for now. Perfect. So now it's time to configure the VSTS, Visual Studio Team Services. This is where the DevOps part really comes through. The repository or CICD will be there and everything. So if you don't have a Visual Studio Team Services, you should really do it. It's free and you could be 5 team members for free. It's really good. So I already have one, so I will pick mine. Voila. For the name of the project, I will be super original and take Cloud in 5 Minutes. And then we see that it already suggests the same name for my website and we'll pick a location. So let's create it East US. And let's do it. So now what's happening in the background is Azure will create for us a template of our project. We'll compile it. Of course, in our case right now, it's static, so no compile. But if it was a .NET or Java or something else, it will be compiled. It will run tests, create the artifact, and then deploy it in the real portal. We will also have application insight pre-connected to our template. So you got everything packed in one few clicks and you're ready to go. So perfect, it's already created. So here we are in the DevOps Blades. So we have a bunch of here little shortcuts for the VSTS. So we have the home page, a repository, the build, the release, the agile backlog. So we have all that. If you don't know VSTS, go create your account. It's free and it's really, really, really worth it. So here we see our CI/CD pipeline. So we see the code was created and added to our solution. Right now we see that the build is running, so it's not deployed yet. So if I click on my website, I should see that the website is there, but it's an empty shell. So let's have a look. And exactly that. So while it's deploying, let's go see in VSTS. So I have the code repository. So let's go get the code. So this is the repository in Git, and if I want to clone it, I have here, so it's like any Git or GitHub, it's really similar. So let's take that URL, and now from Visual Studio Code, double click on that. So from VS Code, I will open the console, do a Git clone, I will paste my URL right away. So I select the path where I want to go, so just in dev. Now I need to enter my credentials, so voila, I see right now all my code is there, and of course it's a static website, so it's pretty drab. So okay, so this is the website, we'll change that, but before I do, we will check if the deployment is done. So let's go back in the portal, and if we refresh that, so yes, it is succeed, so let's open it. See, yeah, success. So now What we will do is try the CICD done for us. So let's change this for cloud 5 minutes. Yeah. So we'll save it. And now because I'm in VS Code, I have Git integrated. So quick fix. I will add this file, commit. Now I will push. Of course, credential. Now if I'm quick enough, I will go in the, so if I go in the pipeline, so now we see that it's in progress. Of course, for us, the compile will be super quick, but if it was .NET, it will have been a little bit longer. So succeed. If we go in release, so the build was success, no mistakes. Of course, you could add tests and have a little bit more stuff in your build. Right now, it's very, very basic, obviously. Releases, the second release is in progress. And now it's done. So if we go back to our application and we refresh, we see our change. So it's pretty cool. Everything packed together. So you got your code and it did like a first pass doing like your build, your release, deployment. We didn't have a look, but if we look here, we have even application inside that is already pre-configured and integrated to our application that we just deployed. So it's really, really great. So everything is packed, few clicks, and everything is done for you. The only downside that I found it yet is if you delete this, it will fantastically do the job to delete your website, your application inside, but it will also deploy the projects. Where is your repository, your code repository? I would have preferred like a checkbox uncheck, but you know, this is really minor. Obviously, it's really awesome. Like next project I'm doing, I'm using that for sure. If you want to know more about the DevOps best practices, join us on June 16. It's the Global Azure Bootcamp. So around the globe, you have an event, the full day for DevOps people. You would like to know if a bootcamp is available close to you? Go to the globaldevopsbootcamp.com website and check. Personally, I will be part of the Ottawa one, and I know one is also available in Montreal. I hope to see you there. I hope you liked this video and I hope it was useful. So now, go create your own project. See you next week. Bye-bye.